When jQuery first came out, it made a bunch of things a lot easier than just using normal JavaScript. However, vanilla JavaScript has caught up a little bit with jQuery, and a lot of things that jQuery made a lot easier, vanilla JavaScript can do it just as easily. Let's go through some of the new vanilla JavaScript alternatives to jQuery methods. Well, here's how you select an element. So here's the jQuery way of selecting an element, and then here's the vanilla JavaScript way of selecting an element. It's only a few more characters to do the JavaScript way. Now let's see how to remove an element. So that's how you would remove an element in jQuery. And then let's see how you would remove an element in JavaScript. As you can see, it's exactly the same. Now let's see how to prepend an element. Let's change this to prepend. Now in the parentheses, we have to put what other element we're going to prepend. And then the vanilla JavaScript way. And again, it's exactly the same. If you want to insert an element before another element, you can use before. And this time, I'm just going to copy and paste because it's exactly the same. If you want to replace an element with another element, replace with. And again, it's exactly the same with vanilla JavaScript. If you want to find the closest ancestor that matches a given selector, you just use closest. And then you pass in the selector, div. And again, we're just going to copy and paste because this is another thing that's been implemented in normal JavaScript. Now we're going to go over a few things that are a little longer in vanilla JavaScript. So jQuery does make them easier, but they're still pretty easy in JavaScript. The first one is fade in. So here's how you're going to fade in an element in jQuery. In vanilla JavaScript, first you're going to have to use some CSS. So you're going to have to put in the initial CSS here. You're going to put display none, opacity 0, transition 0.8 seconds. So it's not going to be displayed at the beginning. And now you're just going to put in this other code. lm.style.display equals block. So you're going to have to set the display to block. And then you're just going to do request animation frame. And you're going to set the opacity to 1. So it's going to start at 0 and go up to 1 in 0.8 seconds. And yeah, for the fade in, you still have to select the item. I didn't mean to delete that. Another thing that jQuery has is .animate. So the .animate method would look like this to animate an object. So you're just going to pass in all the CSS properties you want to animate and the time, 1500 milliseconds. Now JavaScript now has the Web Animations API that makes animation pretty easy, and it gives you a lot more power than the .animate method from jQuery. So here's how you're going to animate in vanilla JavaScript. Again, it's .animate. And you just pass in the initial state of the element, the CSS, and then the state of the CSS after it's been animated, and then the length of the animation, 1000 milliseconds. So another key selling point of jQuery in the past has been Ajax. jQuery made it a lot easier to do Ajax instead of using the XML HTTP request. So here's one of the ways to do Ajax in jQuery. So you're going to pass in the URL, and then if it's success, you're going to do something with this data. JavaScript now has the fetch API. With the fetch API, it's almost as simple. See, you're going to pass in the URL, and then you're going to put what's going to happen with the data. Now here's the almost catch to doing things with vanilla JavaScript. Some of these things are still not supported by Internet Explorer and Edge. However, I say almost catch because pretty much everything can be polyfilled, and polyfilling may be easier than you think. There's a website called polyfill.io. If you just put in this one line of code at the top of your website, everything will be polyfilled. It will automatically check which browser the user of the website has and only bring in the code that's needed for that specific browser. So only brings in the polyfill code that's absolutely necessary to bring that browser up to date. So you may be thinking, if JavaScript has all these things, do I still need to learn jQuery? Well, it's still good to become familiar with it because jQuery is still used in a lot of websites. So you're probably going to come in contact with it eventually. You should just know that for a lot of things, you don't even really need jQuery for. This whole video was based on an article by Ollie Williams called Now More Than Ever You Might Not Need jQuery on CSSTricks.com. I highly recommend checking out the original article. I have the link in the description. Well, thanks for watching. My name is Beau Carnes. Don't forget to subscribe and remember, use your code for good.